Hello guys, it is August the 9th, 2010. Well, I got one-fifth, well, I don't know. This week's gonna be weird for me, because I took Tuesday off to go to a concert with Mark, and then I switched days with the girl at the end of the week, so I'm actually gonna be working Friday for her, and she's gonna work my Monday for me. So it's like I kind of got like all these weird days off in the middle here and there. But it worked out because I tried to take Sunday off and they denied me because Mom and I are going to Boonville. So I, when Holly asked to take those, you know, to switch days because she was wanting Friday off, I was hoping she'd say Sunday, Monday. And I'm like, I'll take Sunday. But Monday worked out okay. Mom can still work that out. Boonville always sends us these free coupons. Motel room stay coupons, so it's like, why the heck not? Yeah, so it's gonna be a weird week for me, with all these weird days off in the middle, and, you know, here, there, but, it's actually gonna probably be a better week, because then it's like, I'm gonna feel like I get some time off, because I'm like, I'm not gonna be here then, and then I am gonna be here then, and not then, and, you know, I mean, when I don't work Monday, by the time I come back, it's gonna be like a 3-day work week. Off Tuesday, work Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, off Saturday, back Sunday, off Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and then it's Friday again for me, so yay! But anyway, you may remember that I said a video or two back, I can't even remember, I'm behind myself, yeah, I know. I don't even have Matt's birthday party posted yet, so sorry guys. Well, by the time you see this one, I won't have to be sorry anymore because you'll have seen it. Autumn's very excited, she can't wait to make her YouTube debut. I don't know about anybody else, but, you know. So I was trying to fix my problem that I had with running out of money and no longer having Obama money. I got paid last week, so that worked out okay. But then it was just like, I'm missing a bit because I was in the hole when I got paid. I didn't get my full paycheck. So I needed a couple hundred. I did the math. And I figured up I needed $400. I was going back and forth. I was like, well, I could get a payday loan for that much. Then I have to pay it every 2 weeks. And I got the idea. I'm like, if I go to Tower Loan, then it's just it's a monthly payment. It's a once a month payment. And their monthly payments are usually pretty cheap. And then I thought, well, that's not definite money. One time I went in there this is back when, before I had my Obama money, I think I applied for a couple hundred dollars. I can't even remember what it was, but they wouldn't give it to me because she was like, unfortunately, your debt to income ratio is so out of whack right now. And I was thinking, exactly, that's what I'm trying to fix. But, you know, at the time, as we'll find out later, I think they said they could give me like 100 and something, you know, which was nowhere near what I needed. But I thought to myself, I'll get as much as Tower Loan will give me. And then I'll get the rest in a payday loan, because then there's only that specific amount that will be due every 2 weeks, which is, you know, with the at least the payday loan place that I go to, it's every 2 weeks. I haven't looked around to see what else is available. I just keep going to Quick Cash. So I thought, I'll just go to Tower Loan, see what they'll give me, and then get the rest in a payday loan. But I also had this thing that from World Finance, something that was an approved $800. And I was thinking, all I have to do is call them. It's pre-approved. I definitely have at least $800 from them, so that'll be good, you know. But then I'm like, that's twice as much money as I need. Like, I don't need $800. I don't need to be that much more in debt, you know. That's twice the amount I need. That's twice the amount of debt that I'm going to be put into when I sign up for this loan. So I thought about it, and I'm like, maybe I should just go with the Tower Loan thing, because I've dealt with them before. They financed my washer and dryer from Fox Appliance, which apparently isn't there anymore. I don't know if they went out of business or if they just moved, but it's not there anymore, it looks like. So I got one of the last appliances from them, apparently. And they sent me this check in the mail that all I had to do was deposit it, and boom, I was in debt to them again. Which worked out at the time, because it's like I needed the money, you know, so I just got further and further in debt with them. Which is why when I went to get a third loan with them, it was rejected, you know. My debt-to-income ratio was so out of whack. Imagine that. But then I got my Obama money, and it was fine for a while, until I ran out of it and wasn't paying enough attention and was being stupid and let myself get in the hole. I'm like, I don't need that much money. I only need $400. Let me call Tower Loan. Well, I was going to go, but it's like, let me see. Let me just take a look over here. It says 90 degrees, and it's just now 11 o'clock, so it's a hot motherfucker out there, okay? So I thought, I'll just call Tower Loan, because I don't want to get up there, put in the application, and then have her say, because the boss isn't there until noon or something, you know, until after lunch. So I don't want to walk all the way up there, put in the application, and her say, okay, well, come back later. Because then I had to walk up there twice. I thought I'll just call them. And then I was thinking to myself, $400, that would, because I'm going to the concert, you know, Tuesday, and then, which is probably going to require some eating out, I would assume. And then, you know, I'm going to Boonville with Mom next Monday. So I'm like, that's going to, I mean, not only Boonville, we go to Boonville for Olive Capri, as you know, from the Boonville. Hopefully all that water won't be around Boonville at the time, which Drew still hasn't watched, I don't think. But I'll put a link somewhere up here so that you can get back to it. Easy access. I'm all about the easy access. Because I'm one of those just-in-case sort of people. It's just like over at the apartment, I wanted to have a TV and a cable connection. A TV with cable in the guest room, even though I never had guests. But I'm like, well, just in case I ever have guests and they want to watch TV in the guest bedroom, I'll have cable hooked up to the TV. It never happened. But I'm one of those just-in-case people. So I was thinking to myself, I'm like, maybe I'll ask for $425, because then I would definitely have enough money, you know, blah, blah, blah. I was thinking to myself, okay, call Tower Loan, don't get out in the heat, ask for $425. So I call Tower Loan. I've obviously worked with them before. So she looked up my name, blah, 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 whatever. And she's like, how much were you wanting to apply for today? And I was like, $425. She's like, $425? Like, it confused her that I was only asking for $425. It's just like, I peace on you, $425. She proceeds to tell me, she's like, well, our loans start at, guess what? Guess what Tower Loan's loans start at? $800. Which I've been pre-approved for because of, you know, working with them last time. I was never late on payments, you know. And then, I mean, I paid off way early because I got that Obama money in. So I really tried, guys, to not get in twice as much debt as I needed to. But apparently that's just not going to work out today. I mean, that'll be plenty of money. And she was telling me on the phone, she's like, well, you know, if you don't need that much, you know, once you get the check and deposit it, you can always come in and, you know, make a payment on your loan, do something else with it. You know, of course she had to mention the do something else with it. Cause she's like, we want you to stay in debt with us as long as humanly possible. But at least, I mean, I've definitely been pre-approved for, it was so funny. It was just, she was like, she was so confused that I asked for $425. She's like, well, we don't do that. Like, I would like to be in less debt. I tried, you know, but, I have to wait until about 12:30-ish. She's going to give me a call when the boss gets back in so that I can walk up there and get my loan. So my money problems, I'm making it worse for the time being, but at least, like I said, I'm not, because before I got my Obama money, it was, I was in debt to, like I said, I was in debt to Tower Loan twice because I had two separate loans with them. So I was getting payday loans to help me skim by, but then on top of my two payday loans, I would have to pay quick cash back, and it was just, oh my god, it was such a horrible vicious cycle. It worked, but it was something that I would not want to do if I hadn't had that $6,000, you know, $150 coming from Mr. Obama. You know, it's not a good system. You know, it's the Robin Peter to pay Paul sort of thing, and it worked if you needed it to, but it was not, oh, that was such a, I just wanted to be done with it all. I don't get stressed out about too much. I don't get angry about too much, but when that money issue, and even this is a little bit frustrating, but it's my own stupidity that got me in this problem. If I had paid more attention and realized, hey, you're, and I even knew my Obama money was running out, I would not have gotten in the hole Luckily, it was only like 100 and something, I think. But that's bad enough, you know. And I'm going to get it fixed. I'm going to have a once-a-month payment to these people. And, like, you know, hopefully I can get them paid off really quickly and just be done with them. At least my debt-to-income ratio isn't so out of whack anymore that, you know, they've approved me from the last time I was with them. So it works out. That's basically it. I'm just sitting around waiting for the lady from Tower Loan to call me. So that I need to maybe catch up on some people's vlogs, because I get terribly behind on those. Like, actually, one of the newer ones that I've gotten interested in is Southern Comfort. He's only been doing this for like a week and a day or two, but he's a really cool guy from Mississippi, and you know, he's a real down-to-earth guy. I mean, he's real. What you see in his vlog is who he is, you know, and I like that. He's a really cool dude, so, and it's just like, Jonathan Boomer, I've gotten behind on Jonathan Boomer, and Wolverina, I'm just about, you know, I get in this terrible thing where I come in, and I sit down in my chair, and maybe I try to do something, and I just doze off for the rest of the day, and then, like, I'm up for a few hours, and then I'm thinking I should lay down and get a power nap before work, and I've spent a lot of time sleeping lately, which kind of sucks. Maybe I'll get some of that caught up on or something. I don't know. But I've got like at least an hour and a half wait to get my money, so to get in twice as much debt as I was wanting to today. But, you know, whatever. I guess it worked itself out, so. And it'll work itself out. Tower Loan is, I mean, they had low monthly payments before, so this shouldn't be a big deal. Here's another one of my crappy outros that you just love so much.
1, 2, 3.